Hi, this is Patty, the Shabby Pink Stamper, and I'm here with my project for Gone Artsy, Deb Shop. And so, if you saw my design team goodie package that I had received a couple months ago, I think, it was this altered metal frame by Ingvild Blome. I think that's how you say her name. And it was blue. This is an altered one, but this is what it was. I will put all the links from Deb's shop down below, so you'll know if you want to order it. And this thing actually sits up. It has this little leg here, but for the sake of showing you the video here of what I made, this is the frame, and I colored it up. It was the blue frame, as you can see more of the blue back there. But I took some white paint and some pink paint, and then I even distressed it a little bit with some of my distressing tool, with the Tim Holtz distress ink in different places. And this is the mold that I'm going to show you. These are molds, and this is a mold that I'm going to show you today how to make and what you can do with those molds. And I love them. They're so much fun. But first, let's talk about the project here. I'm trying to get all this lighting just right, but these are my daughters, and so I took a photo of them, and I layered it on top of another piece of brown paper that I had distressed the edges, and then I popped that on top of this chipboard piece by Cherry Baldy. It's one of hers. I was just at the retreat, so I got that. So I put that piece back here, and then I kind of dab the edges and with blue. And so there's some blue here on the picture. There's blue around the edges there. This is my younger daughter who still lives here. And this is my older daughter who is a mom to five. And I use the paper in the background is from Salvage District, Prima. This is a Prima frame, the metal frame, Prima paper that you can get at Deb's shop. And then this is the Salvage District flowers. So this one here. So it already comes with this, with the beaded, copper beaded center. And this is from another line. I think that's from, no, it could be the Salvage District too, I'm not sure, but I took the two blue flowers and the sprig there, and what I did was I put a little dab of color in the center of the flower, and then I put some of the copper microbeads. Let's see if you can see it. Can you see that? The copper microbeads in the center of that flower, in the center of that flower. And then also on the sprays, I just dabbed some glue, and then I put some of the copper microbeads. There you can see it there. And then there you can see. And this is a Prima, they have some metal distressed hearts, and I know that you can get those in Deb's shop right now. I'm pretty sure she still has the hearts. Okay, and then this is a Prima wood shape there, and it says this is love. This is a crystal from the Salvage District that was in my design team package. I actually bought, it was in my design team package that I haven't posted yet, and also in my original package that I got from Deb from the Tales of Me paper, I think. Maybe not. And then, as you can see, I used up the three flowers that were the Salvage District flowers. Those are the dark gray, grayish. Okay. So I think that explains my project. here, except for the molds. Okay, so I painted, I made these molds, and let's see which one it is. Oh, it's this one right here. I used these molds here, these two shapes, and this one. So these are the three, and this is from number four, so it's mold number four. And then I just painted them to match my project, so it blends right in. So much fun. You could do so much with these molds. And should I zoom in? Because boy, when you zoom in, you really get to see what it looks like. I mean, they're just gorgeous. So, that is my project. My daughters, they love each other. I love this project. It was so fun. And actually, I did this where I can take out the back and change it all up if I want. You know, if it should get dusty or something like that, where, because you can bend these and you can remove this backing metal piece. And I kept everything glued just to that. So, just to that paper. Even the paper I didn't glue down, so I could change it if I want. And it may stay like this forever. But I really like it. I really love it. I have it displayed in here, but I'm going to have that displayed in my hallway. All I'm doing is really working this. Trying to just soften it up, get it ready. I mean, you don't always have to do it, but I've had it sitting there a while. I mean, zipped up in the baggie, but I managed to pick up some glitter. Okay, so it just helps to kind of work it so you're not left with a bunch of lines or things like that. So let's try this clock. And just because I've done this a few times, I'm just pushing it down into the mold. And you don't want it to be super fat or anything in the center, and I want to make sure that I get every detail. And I just try to clean it up around the edge. You know, actually it doesn't really matter because you can cut it off. You know, I usually pull them out when they're almost dry, but not all the way dry. Just depending. If it's real easy to get out, then I'll pull it out. If it's not, and it's real intricate design, and it's coming apart or something, then I just smash it all back, you know. Well, it depends on how dry it is. Anyway, so I try to leave it till it's good and dry, and see how, let me try and zoom in closer, find the zoom here. Okay. Just my camera. I'm sorry. This is probably making you... But see how it's missing a little bit right there? All you do is you just start working it over to that corner. And that's it. So I just make sure I press it down really well. In fact, I turn mine over and then I press it down. Sorry. With my whole hand. And it doesn't matter. No one's going to see the back. And I actually take my Cricut tool, which I put away, of course, and I will, it's like a razor, it's like a flat razor in a way, and I will just kind of zip through it if I feel like there's a big lump. but there's no lumps. So some people pull it out right away. I don't, but you can, so I'm just going to show you. You can pull it out right away. See, I went over. Oops. I went over here, so I'm just using my fingernail to scrape that away because it wasn't releasing. They're very bendable, flexible, so you can. This is why I don't pull mine out though, because I don't want to mess up the design at all. But you can. I just want to I'm going to do it for the sake of the video to show you. Is that not gorgeous? It is gorgeous. So because it came out nicely, I mean, it looks like there's just a little mess up right there, but hey, I mean, I'm not into perfection, and even as it starts to dry, then I might go around. See, there's that little lip there, and I don't like it. When it's drying and almost dry, I will just scrape it a little. So see how easy that is? That's how easy. Oops, my camera is becoming too full. So I hope you got the idea. I'm going to go ahead and try and do this as long as I can. See, I'm working the piece. For these long ones, I would kind of get them long, right? Go like this, and then smash it into the mold, pushing it over, and that's how easy it is. I'm telling you, it is so easy. So at the end of my video, I will show you, because my camera's about to die, I will show you what this looks like too. And so head on over to Deb's shop. She's got all these. Oh, and make sure you clean these afterwards. These are clean. I did clean them, but you can't really see on video. But there's a few little white dots, but I took the brush that I used to clean my potatoes, you know, one of those vegetable cleaning brushes, and I just kind of went in there and just scrubbed a little bit, so it came out nice and clean. If you have big chunks in there, it's going to, you know, of course, affect your design. It's going to put a bubble in there or whatever. And you can wet your paper clay to get it, if it's dried out too much, to get it moldable again, but if you have it too wet, when you put it in here, it like leaves little bubbles and stuff. And you definitely won't be able to pull it out until it's dry. And I think the wetter it is, the more shrinkage, because there's going to be some shrinkage, depending on, not all paper clays are equal. So see how easy this is to do. Just fill in the gaps and press. It's just paper clay. So just like I did the snowman, you just add to it. You can't see, but I can see there's a little bit of a missing piece right there. You just pop it down and fill it in. All right, thanks for watching. If you have any questions, just ask, leave me a comment and I will answer your questions. But right now, if you use my code DTSPL15, you will get an additional, you will get a 15% discount. And her prices are really good. So get on over there to, and I'll leave all the links down below as I do each month. So you won't want to miss out on these. You really won't. Thanks for watching. Like I said, at the end of the video, I'm going to show some pictures of the projects that I've done. And I'll show you this and that one. You can color these. I'm going to keep talking until my video dies. You can color these with your sprays. You can color them with your... this one here, I used alcohol inks, and I just dropped the blue, the pink, and then I took some of my distressing tool, and I kind of went over it to darken it, and that's the part that bugs me. I don't like it. So just play with them. I think this one I did gesso first. I put some gesso on it, but you don't have to use gesso on these things. But anyway, so alcohol inks work. And the alcohol ink I used was actually from my Copic markers, my refills. That's what I used on this. And so you can use your sprays. So let's get to the molds. I did a little video till my battery on my video camera ran out. And so I'm starting again in the middle. So this is... just been about an hour maybe since I did that video of this. So it's still wet, so you cannot color it. I wouldn't color it while it's still wet. And I think on the video I did this one, so we could pull it out. It's still wet, but it's only been about an hour maybe. See how moldable that is. How fun and easy is that? Now see where I have some over, you know, I've gone over in the back. It just comes off real easy. And even as it's, you know, dry some more, then I can clean that up. Like right here. See? Very easy. Very simple. There's cleanup that I need to do, but I'm telling you, you could do it later. I don't want to mess with it too much and crack it. So I'm going to set that off to the side. And then, I think as my video was dying, I was doing this one. Is that not beautiful? So these are going to be, that's how easy it is. I'm just going to set those off to the side here. And see, they came out pretty clean. But you should keep these clean. So I'm going to show you all the videos. I'm going to show you all the molds that I have made, and we're going to color some. What good is it if I show you how to make the molds and then we don't color them together? There's a few. Let's see. How about another? This is the piece that I used on the bottom of my frame. This piece. And I do have this piece that I made before. And I use these on the picture that I'm going to show you on my canvas at the end of the video. So they dry good. Good and hard. This is nice and flat. Now, there is going to be a little bit of shrinkage. So this has a little bit of a... can you see that? But it's no big deal. If I was to glue that down, it's going to stay glued down. But this one's flexible. It's a little more flexible than, say, this one would be, right? Because this would probably crack. But it's okay. It works. But whatever. It's all going to work just fine. So let's color these up. You can color them with your inks. And like I said before in the last one, I colored this piece with my refill inks from my Copic markers. So I'll show you how easy that is. I haven't even opened this or used this refill yet. It's RV13. I'm just grabbing a color. This is probably going to be fairly bright. It's a bright pink. And let's say I want it more in the... I'm going to stain my... I'm going to end up staining my... Okay, see how it just absorbed? Because this is really dry. And let's try some... This is a Prima Color Bloom, but I have a wide range of... I'm going to try not to move my camera, but... I keep these papers nearby, so let's use them before I regret staining up my mat, my self-healing mat. And it's already staining and getting dirty and it's driving me crazy, so let's do that. Okay, so this piece here, I told you that was going to be a bright pink. Well, I think because that other stuff just absorbed so well, it didn't flow. I should have sprayed it first and then it's okay because you can also use paint. Grab a paintbrush. Okay. So you could just dab it. Oh, I'm not liking that, but let's see what other colors I have. I love that brown. It's actually an antique gold. That could be pretty cool. A crabby. Ooh, I see, because I have lots of... So much for that one. I mean, I have other tops to exchange it out, but I'm not going to do that right now. So let me see, what else do I have? I have other colors. In fact, I have this pink right here. I have so many colors. This looks like it would match more of that alcohol ink color. And you can use paint. So I've used paint. I gessoed them up. So that, the other ones that I used, and this one I did not. So that's why I think it just absorbed that color. You know, if you gesso it, then you have more control. Because it's not going to just absorb it all so quickly. Sorry guys, this is taking a while. give this color a try. I told you, that is almost the exact same color as that other stuff. And I don't want to get it too wet because, like I said, it was paper. And now, you know, we're going to switch it up. I mean, get it re-wet. So I don't know if you could see that, but I like it. In fact, I have some gold. We could try and spray it with some of this gold. Or instead of spraying, if I want more control in certain areas, then I can just dab it. Okay, let me pick that up so you can see. So that's a gold. Let me lay it down there and zoom in. See how pretty that is? Love it. Only you'd want to make sure you got all of it. So I'm just going to try and get some of this off the... off my paintbrush. It really is pretty. Just depends on the project you're going to use it on. Gorgeous. I love it. So it almost looks like metal. Okay, so let's try this one. But that, to me, would either have to go with the gold. See, I think I do like it when I gesso it so you have more control. You can wipe away. But let's do this. Why I'm doing the brown first is I want that, and it's got a gold. See, it's, can you see that on the paper? Oops. It's, it's got a gold shimmer to it. Okay, so we've got that. And now I'm going to go with major gold. Let me zoom out. I'm sorry, you guys. I'm sitting here doing this all thinking you can see me. And you can't because I've zoomed in too close and moved my camera. See? Although I love this. I love this piece. My nails need to be done, but I've been working on some projects, so I thought, no, I am not going to go yet till I was done. Oh. You can always add more color. I even have a white here. I wanted to add some white. Too, I am not shaking these all up because of the noise it's probably making on the video. It's gorgeous. I'm telling you, I love it. I have so much fun playing with these. Now, I've been using paint, so after these dry or after I dry them with a heat gun, you can also take some white paint and just, or a pink paint or a black paint or whatever it is you're looking for, whatever type of color you're looking for, and then just with a dry brush kind of go over the top of it. It's hard to tell because my fingers are all red now, or pink, but that and gold, but that is so pretty. That is so beautiful. So I love it. So much fun. In fact, I have a tiny bit of pink paint, and I'll show you. Because this one I gessoed first, and then I used my my inks, the same inks that I used. Let me just show you how you can. What I didn't like is when I used the Tim Holtz Distress ink. And so you could barely see it shining through. I don't know why this color, the lighting is changing it. But it's gorgeous. Okay, so let's just touch this a little bit with this. It's a pink cream coat. Touch of pink, okay? That's all I'm doing is I'm just, oops, too much going over it. And usually I would let it dry some before I touch it. This one looks so pretty and shimmery. I don't know if I want but I have pink in my house. I have blue. Since I was pregnant with my see, I love it. Gorgeous. So you guys, you have to play with these. You have to. I hope that you will give it a try. Switch out to a clean. I mean, you choose the colors. You choose what you're going for. But what I've learned today, because I haven't, I've always gessoed mine, is if you want more control and less absorption, sorry about that, I would use the gesso. If you just want to play and get what you get, which, I mean, these look beautiful. This one was gessoed. Still beautiful. I love it now more than I did before. And I might take some of that gold on that one, too. But these are absolutely gorgeous. They just, I like the shimmer. So these are the ones that you saw me on the video do. Oops, sorry. So that's drying. I'm not going to let it dry on this paper. That's what I learned, because the paper will absorb the... But you saw how fast and quick that was to make these. And see, this is over. You know, when I... You can just... Once it's dry, I just kind of rub over it with my finger even, and it just... will dry, and then you don't have to worry about breaking your